we believe in a doctrine called dispensational salvations. What does that mean? What that means is that we believe that, for example, Christians are saved by faith, not by works. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, but here's the problem. There are other verses in the Bible that seem to show you can lose your salvation or you have to do works with your faith for your salvation. The simple solution for us is we divide it. So we divide those verses to an Old Testament passage. And then the other salvation we divide to a tribulation timeline. That's what you're going to find out about those verses. It's that simple. That's why we can argue we're faith, truly faith alone, not by works, whereas these timelines are faith and works. But there's a group out there that hate dispensational salvation, which has rescued many souls out there. So what they're going to insist is that they're going to insist that you get rid of these boundary lines, combine all of it together, and think they were all saved the same way. That is total dishonesty. That is not going to convince a cult out there when you read them a verse and insist it's faith alone, if that verse is referring to a tribulation salvation by faith and works. Now, James chapter 2, they insist I was desperate right here. I had a desperation in trying to defend myself in this passage. Okay, fine, I'm so desperate. Okay, let's put it that way, okay? Let's see how desperate I am, okay? If you look at James chapter 2, what they're going to mention right here, what we believe, first of all, let me explain so that there's no confusion. First of all, James chapter 2 is an infamous verse that is used for faith and works for salvation, right? Okay, our simple solution is this is for the tribulation timeline. That's it. Now, I'll put a video below this video. Was Abraham saved by faith or works? Just watch that video and then you'll understand why. I'm not going to argue that right here. I'm just going to take it as it is. This is faith and works, okay? All right, resuming on. So this is faith and works for salvation, James 2. That's what we insist. Dishonest people, they're going to insist, no, this is faith alone. No, because it says dead faith. If you watch my video about Abraham wasn't saved in James 2, dumb. If you watch that video, I'll put that video link below. I was like, no, when you argue dead faith, that means that your salvation by faith in Jesus Christ, which is not living in you, wow, that's a serious problem. Don't you believe, look, my faith is not dead in Jesus Christ. It's alive. Yep. It's living in Jesus Christ. Why do you think Paul said the just shall live by faith? Why do you think that James would give an opposite interpretation, justified by faith and works at a different timeline? See, the wording right here has to do with salvation, whether you like it or not. Now, what they're going to insist is this, is that all the verses that I use to prove that, look, if you want to argue that Christians have a backslidden life, that the Christians, that they're showing some part in their life where it's not alive, it's not going to be called dead faith, it's called dead works. Again, watch my video, which I'll put below. That's what I mentioned right here. It's not accurate to call it dead faith, it's more accurate to call it dead works. So dead works would apply to Christians right here, not a dead faith. But they're going to insist, no, Christians are a dead faith. What in the world? So then I pull up my verses. And you know what they're going to do with those verses? They're going to use in those verses, that's because the works follow their faith. So they're going to say, because the works follow their faith, that's why they have a dead faith. So because they have dead works, that's why they have a dead faith. You know what the simple argument against that is? This is so easy. Not one single verse that they're going to use. And let me help them out here. They're going to also use Galatians 5. They're going to use the book of John, chapter 15. They can use whatever verse they want, trying to prove a dead faith. You're not going to find one verse in your Bible that it exactly said a dead faith. You will not see that anywhere. But I will show you something. All over the Bible, there are dead works for saved Christians. 1 Corinthians chapter 3. The works that they lay down at the judgment seat of Christ. What happens? It becomes dead and combustible. Look at all those verses I mentioned in my previous video. It mentions about dead works. That's the idea. Even your beloved Galatians 5, what's going to mention right here is that there's a distinction right here. If a Christian follows the works of the flesh, that's what he even said right there. The works of the flesh in Galatians 5. That's why you're going to be dead. Not dead faith, it's dead works. Now, here's something that, let's give them the advantage. I'll let them win, okay? Let them win, okay? I'm going to give them so much advantage. Let's say right here that these works come from their faith. Let's put that those kind of pretty words in. Look at James chapter 2. Context, right? Gene Kim doesn't go by context. Context. Oh, be quiet, man. I use context all the time, and you avoided it, which makes me wonder why that I could be wrong about this, but why did you avoid my other videos concerning tribulation salvation where I deliberately went by context? You know why? You're scared, because you'll be proven dumb. Maybe I'm wrong, though. So if I'm wrong, I'll take that back. Okay, but let's look back over here, James chapter 2. James chapter 2, and then we'll read verse 5. Hearken, my beloved brethren, hath not God chosen the poor of this world, what?
Rich in faith.
This has to do with salvation. You know why? Keep reading. And heirs of the kingdom which he hath promised to them that love him. But ye have despised the poor. Do not rich men oppress you and draw you before the judgment seats? Do not they blaspheme that worthy name by the which ye are called? See, this has to do with salvation here. These rich people are lost because they're not rich in their faith, whereas the poor people are. If you want to insist this is Christian fellowship, Christian walk, no, this is talking about rich people. You think that these are saved people then? No, this is talking about those who did not follow that faith like the poor people, rich people who are lost sinners. Doesn't say hell. It doesn't say, oh my goodness, you just want me to find the word hell in every verse. That's your problem. Didn't you know Paul never mentioned the word hell? He hardly even used the word hell. Maybe he'll use some verses like wrath, but most of the time he'll refer to a tribulation context. But let's skip that, okay? Let's look at the book of James chapter 5. James chapter 5, verse 1. Go to now, ye rich men, weep and howl for your miseries that shall come upon you. Your riches are corrupted, and your garments are moth-eaten. Your gold and silver is cankered, and the rust of them shall be a witness against you, and shall what? Eat your flesh as it were what?
Fire.
Ye have heaped treasure together for the what? That, you know what that is? Lost people burned up by Jesus Christ at his coming. Oh, that's not it. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, did you read that? When Jesus Christ comes down on the lost people in fiery vengeance? What in the world? These people, man, they just don't want to admit salvation here.
That's right.
No matter how clear, you know what's interesting about them? No matter how clear I'm going to argue to you right here, it's not going to convince you. That's the problem.
Look at James
chapter 2, verses 5 through 7, which we read, and then 8 through 13 right here. Now, remember, 5 through 7 is the rich people, right? Now look at 8 through 13. It's continuing that context, right? It's continuing the context of that's why you got to follow the law, you got to feed the poor, you got to help each other. But look at verse 13. For he shall have judgment without mercy that hath shown no mercy, and mercy rejoiceth against judgment. That is referring to a lost person right here. This has nothing to do with the judgment seat of Christ. Now, if they want to insist right here, this is their argument. Verse 19, you'll notice in verse 19, I argued, thou believest that there is one God, thou doest well. The devils also believe and tremble. This verse proves this has to do with salvation. Otherwise, why does God have to mention the lost condition of devils here? Their argument around this is this manner. They'll say, well, this has nothing to do with that. What this has to do is that the devils, they're afraid of God's judgment. So that's why Christians should be afraid of God's judgment too. Oh, gotcha. And you think my hand was in the cookie jar when I actually explained all of that away. Your hand was in the cookie jar. Christians are in the same judgment as Satan, huh? And the devils? Oh, uh-oh. The same judgment? Uh-oh. Here's another thing right here. That judgment is for lost souls. They go to hell. That's something you understand. Uh-oh. Here's another thing right here. If you want to insist this judgment, look at verse 13. This is the judgment they're talking about, we read, right? This differs from 2 Timothy 1. Look at 2 Timothy 1. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 18. No mercy at the great white throne judgment, you got to understand. Oh, isn't it interesting if you read Revelation chapter 20? They're judged by their works, and then they're cast into the lake of fire. Oh, isn't that interesting right there? Okay, Let's bypass that. Let's look at 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 18. The Lord grant unto him that he may find what? Mercy of the Lord in what? That day. We may find mercy at the judgment seat of Christ. That day is referring to the judgment seat of Christ at 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. Read that. I'm not going to read it. For time's sake, you read that. 1 Timothy 4, 8. Isn't that what it is? That's what it is. Okay, now, here's the thing right here. But in James, look at right here, James chapter 2, verse 13, that judgment has no mercy. Oh, you caught your hand in the cookie jar. These Christians, they're afraid to be judged by God like the devils at verse 19. Yeah, the judgment where you're going to be judged like lost sinners burning in hell. That's why you got to escape that. Wow, you've been debunked right there. Now, I will now wait and see what's going to happen. But see, look at the scripture. Just debunked all the time. Keep digging a hole, buddy. Keep digging a hole. I'm just going to keep quoting verses.
Amen.